Hi students, I am Vikas from HTC. Today we are starting a new series which will cover IELTS writing task 2. In each lecture, I will discuss with you how many numbers of paragraphs an essay should have. And we will do it practically, and you will find an answer essay at the end of each lecture. And we will also discuss the structure of each paragraph in detail. So now, as you can see in the types of essays, the first four types of essays are those where the body paragraph will contain a single idea in each paragraph for each essay. We will see in details how to tackle a single idea within a body paragraph 1 or 2. As you can see, a double question essay, that is at number 1 position. Like if we find an essay where two questions have been asked, let's say what and how. Then in body paragraph 1, we need to answer the question starting with what word, and in body paragraph 2, we have to answer the question starting with the word how, the question word. So in the next, we have agree or disagree at number 2 position. In this kind of essay, we have to take a position, okay? Either we agree or disagree. Then we will justify with arguments within our essay, and we will present the arguments in favor of whatever our position would be. So over here, I will strongly recommend you to take one position, either you agree or disagree, because it's easier for you to present your arguments in favor of your choice. And I won't recommend to be indecisive in this matter. Like if you might say to some extent you agree or to some extent you disagree, that's not the case. I mean, that's not recommended. Okay, so our next essay is discuss both views essay at number 3. Okay, it can also accompany with one's opinion as well. Okay, you can see on the number 4. So sometimes an essay discuss both views and give your opinion. In one question, you can find these two statements, question statements, like discuss both views and give your opinion, or you can also find just discuss both views. Okay, if you are asked to discuss both views only, then the case is very simple. Just provide two body paragraphs with single idea, and in total 4 paragraphs. And that the structure of paragraph will include introduction paragraph on the top, body paragraph 1 with single idea, body paragraph 2 with single idea, and the conclusion paragraph. Okay, so we will discuss in detail how to structure the single idea paragraph, so don't you worry at this stage. Okay, in the fourth one, we have a choice. If you see an essay with discuss both views and give your opinion, in that case we can either include our opinion an additional paragraph to give our opinion, or we can mention our opinion in conclusion paragraph. It will depend upon the type of essay. Okay, so both the question statements at 3 and 4 are going to include single idea paragraphs. That's the main thing. Okay, don't worry, we will see in detail and write lots of essays. Let's see next types of essays from 5 to 7. These are the ones where we have body paragraphs with double idea. Okay, so there is a trick, okay, that you need to understand to avoid any markdown. You can see the question statement can contain plural words, like at position 5 you can see problems and solutions, and at number 6 you can see advantages and disadvantages. We can't just write in body paragraph 1 only one problem and in body paragraph 2 merely one solution. That's not the case, because if we do so, then it will be a single problem as well as a single solution essay, which is contrary to what has been asked. Okay, the question demands problems and solutions, not just one of each. Okay, and if you do so, that's how you can get your marks down, right? What we can do here, we can just write one problem along with one solution in body paragraph 1, and in the next paragraph, body paragraph 2, we can write second problem with solution, with second solution, okay, in the body paragraph 2. And that's how we will have more than one problems and solutions written within one essay. Okay, let's move to the next number, where you can be asked advantages and disadvantages at number 6. Here we will write two advantages in body paragraph 1, whereas in body paragraph 2 we will write couple of disadvantages and vice versa. You can also find advantages and disadvantages essay with to give your opinion as well, so which we can opt to answer by adding one more paragraph, making it 5-paragraph essay, or we can mention our opinion in conclusion paragraph. In that case, essay will have 4 paragraphs. Okay, I hope you grab the idea, and we will discuss in detail in a bit. Okay, let me assure you, in this series we are gonna cover essays in great numbers, so nothing to worry, and hopefully you will learn great amount of knowledge through this series. Last but not the least, we need to write our essays in either 4 or 5 paragraphs. That's the main thing. Okay, we have lots of things to cover in this lecture. I mean the structure of paragraphs and a lot of stuff. Okay, and dear students, I'm also working on spoken ideas, so I would request you to subscribe to my channel and stay connected to fetch the content which may help you in future for your IELTS exams. So now let's read number of essays below, categorized as single idea or double idea. So you can see on the screen we have single argument or idea paragraph essay. Okay, we have 2 over here, and all of them, I mean the number, all of these essays, first of all let me tell you, all of these essays are from IELTS book 8. Okay, I will upload video for each question statement, how to structure and write each paragraph. That will depend upon if you like my videos. Let me read the essay now. Essay on the first position is, nowadays the way many people interact with each other has changed because of technology. In what ways has technology affected the types of relationships people make? Has this become a positive or negative development? As you can see, the first essay is the double question essay. As we can see, the first question is, in what way has technology affected the types of relationships people make? And the second question is, has this become a positive or negative development? First of all, the second question requires your opinion. Okay, either go with positive development or negative development. Therefore, it's a double question essay, because the first question is very simple. Just ask you, what ways has technology affected the types of relationship people make? We will practice this essay today, so I will discuss in details in a while. Okay, our second essay is, some people think that it is better to educate boys and girls in separate schools. Others, however, believe that boys and girls benefit more from attending mixed schools. And the question is, question statement is, discuss both these views and give your opinion. Okay, so you can note here the same question statement which we see at number four types of essays from the list you just saw earlier. So that will be tackled accordingly, and its number is 2 here in this page. So it will be covered in second video that I'll upload later, because today's video I'm gonna cover the first essay, that is the changing the way people communicate with each other. This is the first one. Now we're gonna see essays with double idea paragraph. As you can see, these are going to be 3. Actually, all of these essays have been taken from IELTS book 8, as you know this already. So over here we see question statement 1 by 1. Okay, question, your first essay is, in some countries the average weight of people is increasing and their levels of health and fitness are decreasing. What do you think are the causes of these problems, and what measures could be taken to solve them? Okay, we need to provide causes and measures, which are plural forms of tasks. So we will handle the paragraph by providing double ideas. Okay, in the way which we discussed earlier, and you must have an idea by now, that the body paragraph 1 we will write one cause, one measure, and in second body paragraph we write cause number 2 and its measure. Okay, next one is, today more people are traveling than ever before. Why is this the case? What are the benefits of traveling for the traveler? Okay, as you can see, hopefully you know now how to choose the structure of body paragraph. Like over here, as in body paragraph 1, we will write single idea to address the question why, because it narrates why is this the case. Okay, so in body paragraph 1, you're answering the question why. And for body paragraph 2, we need to write a couple of benefits. So therefore, we need to induct two ideas at least mentioning the benefits. But don't write more than two. Now let's move on to the third one. Increasing the price of petrol is the best way to solve growing traffic and pollution problems. To what extent do you agree or disagree? What other measures do you think might be effective? In this case, we need to write body paragraph 1 with single idea to explain either we agree or disagree, okay, with the narration. Whereas in second paragraph, we need to provide couple of measures as we have seen in previous essay. Hopefully the idea is well understood. Now let's see how we will attempt the structure of body paragraphs. Okay, structure of single idea paragraph. We need to write a paragraph with like introduce the first idea in the first sentence. Okay, and second, third sentence, you should explain the first idea, reason, give the reason, give examples of the first idea, and the fourth one is refer back to the first idea. That is like, first of all, you need to introduce your idea in sentence number one, though not a hard rule to follow the number of sentences. Okay, you can like write the first two narrations, like introduce your idea and explain your idea, giving reason, in just one long sentence or just maybe one or two sentences. Okay, so this is, there's not a hard rule, it's up to you. Okay, then you can give the after giving the idea, introducing the first idea, then you can give the reason, and that may be covered in two, three sentences. Okay, next, give examples of the first idea and refer back to the first idea, which is just to paraphrase your introductory statement that you've used to describe your first idea in this paragraph. I mean, just paraphrase that. Okay, we will practically see this in detail. Okay. The next paragraph structure is with double idea paragraph, and over here you need to introduce set of idea. Okay, advantages, explain first idea, advantage one, and give example of first idea, evidence, and explain second idea, advantage two, and give examples of second idea, evidence, and refer back to first and two. I mean, two ideas, mention two ideas altogether in the last statement. We will practically produce the structure, so you don't have to worry. Please subscribe to my channel and stay connected with my upcoming videos. Now let's move to discuss the number of paragraphs for essay number one, okay, which I told you already that this lecture is going to cover first essay, which is with single idea paragraph, and the question statement is, nowadays the way many people interact with each other has changed because of technology. In what ways has technology affected the types of relationships people make? And second statement is, has this become a positive or negative development? We will cover this essay by writing four paragraphs. As you can see, the first one will be introduction paragraph, that will be paraphrasing of question statement, and along with a description that what our essay will answer, and also we need to state our position in the introduction paragraph. For example, over here we have to declare our position, as the question asks, has this become a positive or negative development? So for example, we can describe that the essay will argue the positives of technology impact upon communication, so that we can just clearly mention that we are focusing on positives of technology impact upon communication. So we have to declare our position clearly in the first introduction paragraph. We will see just in a bit that how we add description in our introduction paragraph. Okay, so for the rest of the paragraphs, we have to write as in body paragraph 1, that represents point 2 here, and we will be answering in what ways Has technology affected the types of relationships people make? So this is the answer of this question will be covered in body paragraph 1. Whereas in body paragraph 2, that is at point 3, we will be answering, has this become a positive or negative development? Definitely, we need to give our opinion in this body paragraph. Need not to mention that the fourth is going to be the conclusion paragraph. Okay, now let's practically see how we will develop each paragraph. Here is the introduction paragraph that says, in recent times, modern technology has evolved the ways of people connecting each other. In the modern era, such an interaction using whatsoever advanced means of communication has a positive impact upon the relationships among people will be discussed in this essay. As you can see, the whole paragraph is paraphrased with additional statements added to it are stating our position as well in the last statement. Okay, we can see over here, such as interaction using whatsoever advanced means of communication has a positive impact upon the relationship among people will be discussed in this essay. So we have taken a clear-cut position as well as we paraphrase the question statement given to us. And this paragraph, introduction paragraph, consists of 42 words. Now we move to body paragraph 1, and we will answer the first task given in the essay, and that is, in what ways has technology affected the types of relationships people make? Let me read the paragraph now. A couple of decades ago, talking to someone unknown was hard to believe, though the development of the latest technologies, specifically the modern communication apps, made it possible to establish connections between people of different territories and establishing relationships. For example, nowadays we often see individuals are indulging in intercontinental marriages and at the same time business relationships. That all became possible due to the available contemporary communication technologies, without which it would have been difficult to realize. So, a point to note here, if I take the word affected, okay, it will be a bit difficult to phrase in my idea, first of all. But if I would check the synonyms of word affected, then one of that is to shape. Okay, that makes my job easy now. So, and now you understand the paragraph better. What is to shape? If I adjust the word shape within my question statement, now you understand my paragraph that is written very better. Okay, the point here is that always remember to make a list of these question words with their synonyms. It will help you generate an idea. So here you are, clear how to write a paragraph on technology helping to shape or form relationships. Okay, and this paragraph contains 78 words. Okay, further you can see the structure has been followed and highlighted with different colors. Okay, that is in parity with the structure we have already discussed earlier. Now we would move to body paragraph 2. This paragraph will explain our opinion regarding, has this become a positive or negative development? I'm going to read this paragraph. The role of communication to globalize the whole world has only been possible due to advanced technology, and it is a very pragmatic approach. Pragmatic, optimistic, positive. Pragmatic approach and bestows many useful impacts. For example, knowledge sharing has been on the top, which was never possible otherwise. On the other hand, instant messaging helps to bolster abrupt decision making to avoid financial losses or any other inconvenience in advance. Overall, it has impacted the whole world to flourish more like a global village. Clearly, we took our opposition in first sentence, which is in complete parity with our structure. Okay, and that is highlighted with green color. And next we have, you can see we follow the same parity. We have like examples, arguments, reasonings, and referring back to our position. Okay, the last statement, which is highlighted in gray color. So you see we follow the same parity as is instructed in our paragraph structure, and hopefully you understood all of it. This paragraph also contains 78 words. Okay, and last we have at the end we need to write a conclusion paragraph of the essay, and that is with 25 words only. I'm going to read this paragraph. To sum up, change in means of communication by modern technologies has left optimistic and positive influence the communities of the world as a whole. Okay, I kept it short and simple with my opinion, and to mention that changes in means of communication affected the whole world. Okay, the conclusion paragraph contains 25 words only. Okay, so in total that is going to be like 223 words essay. Underneath is the answer essay, and the PDF of this essay you can download from a link that will be available in the description. Total essay consists of 223 words, as I told you already. That's all for today. You can see this essay, the whole essay will be available in the form of PDF, which you can download from the link given in this description. I hope you have learned something out of this lecture. If you are still connected so far, I appreciate you, and I believe you want to achieve something with your IELTS test. Please subscribe to my channel and stay connected. Thank you very much. See you soon in the next video.